Do 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 do. Okay. Okay. So let's see what we'll see. Let's see what we see. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We'll be going doing some Godot now. Let's go to this. Let me change to Godot. Okay. And we're ready to go. We're ready to go. So. Let's talk about what we have done last time. Last time, we have been basically working on fixing our normals. Finally, we managed to fix the normals. And everything seems to work fine now. I'm getting correct values. We use the surface tool to confirm those values. And yeah, normals are working great. The shading seems to be correct. The lighting seems to be correct. So the next stage is going to be how to smooth normals. And what smoothing normals means, it means that we actually smoothing, we don't have this kind of like pixelated kind of hard edge surface kind of effect. When you have smooth normals, everything appears smooth. So the shading becomes continuous, right? From face to face and gradual, right? And gradient in essence. So how we do that? Now the surface tool also has a way to smooth normals. It has the ability to create, how we call it? It was called smooth groups. So we're going to implement something similar. And the reason behind that is because we have found out that the surface tool tends to do things a lot slower. For example, for calculating the normals, it was using some kind of complicated technique, like putting things on planes. And I don't know why it was going through all the steps and was taking different considerations into account. So I hope that it will actually implement something that's going to be simpler. Maybe the reason why the surface tool is doing that is because it wants to be more dynamic. But for me, I just want something very simple and something that's really fast. As a matter of fact, there is a possibility that I will be moving this code to GPU as well. Because I don't really see why that wouldn't work, at least for a shader or something like that, right? Anything can be turned into a texture. So yeah, I mean, using shaders is not really something that is really that weird. So, yeah. So before doing that, we have to understand how smooth shading works. We all know that's how smooth it works. You know, I've used it inside Blender. Usually, for most people out there that do 3D games in Godot, they don't have to worry about those things because you just make the model, you're smoothing the areas. First of all, you can smooth only specific faces, right? You don't have to smooth everything. If you want hard edges, for example, it would be a good idea to let those faces be unsmooth. So what's the difference there? What smoothing really means? Well, it means basically that because we have a different normal per vertex, but we give exactly the same value on the same vertex that occupy the same surface. So because those normals, those Maverick normals share the same exact values, we say that we have basically a normal of the surface only, because you take the average of the surface and you create this kind of normal. What we want is we want to take the normal that not just take the consideration the edges of the triangle of the surface, but also the normals that are around that the vertices that are around that face. So vertices that belong to other faces and to other triangles. And that's how we create the average of the normal of that specific vertex, which means that because it takes into consideration what is next to it, not just what is on the triangle itself, but what is the next triangle, the next triangle, the next triangle, that means that it creates, it doesn't create a sudden change in shading, it creates a more gradual shading. And of course, this creates a smooth effect, where we don't really see corners, we don't really see edges, we only see something that is organic. So how we do that? Well, I have found some documentation about it, and it is, let me start closing things because we have, this is from the previous stream, we were doing cute stuff. which is a nice GUI. Let me go here and we do kind of this. This was actually the article that we used last time to find and confirm that we are doing things normally as it should be done. And it was for calculating the normals themselves for simple stuff like flat shadiness. And that's called flat shadiness because the normal of the vertex is always going to be the normal of the surface. So it's not going to have a different value from the other normals that belong to the same vertex of the same triangle. So now we want to create something that has much more gradual values. So how we do that? We do that by... Here is going to start reading, and I'm going to stop in this one, which is basically the entire thing here we have here. So let's see, read that and see what happens here. So it says, a simply sending effect facing ratio. Now that we know how to compute the normal of a point of the surface of an object, we have enough information to create a simple sending effect called facing ratio. This technique consists of computing the dot product of the normal of the point that we want to shade and the viewing direction. Computing the viewing direction is also very simple. Viewing direction. When ray tracing is used, it is simple the opposite direction of the ray that intersected the surface at P. If we don't use ray tracing, the viewing direction can also simply be found a line from the point or the surface to the eye. Okay? Keep in mind that the product of two vectors turns 1 if the vectors are parallel and point in the same direction, and 0 when the two vectors are perpendicular to each other. If the vector points in opposite direction, the dot product is negative, but we use the result of this dot product as a color that we are not interested in negative values anyway. If you need a reminder of the dot product, check the lessons on geometry. To avoid negative results, we need to clamp the result to 0. Okay? So this is the viewing angle, which I assume it plays a role when you calculate shading, smooth shading anyway. Maybe. We'll see. But I don't think we're going to use that. We want to go directly to here. The problem with triangle mesh is that it cannot represent perfectly smooth surfaces unless the triangles are very small. If we wish to apply the facing ratio technique we just described in a polygon mesh, we need to compute the normal of the triangle intersected by the ray and compute the facing ratio as a dot product between this face and the viewing direction. Okay, so it takes the viewing direction into account. The problem with this approach is that it gives the object a faced look as shown in the image below. Okay. So this call it for this Cartesian flat shading. We don't want flat shading, we don't need smooth shading. As mentioned times in the previous lesson, the normal of a triangle can simply be found. We found it. We already had the normal of the surface, or the normal of the triangle, we already had that. So we are fine in this. Where V1, V2 represent the vertices of the triangle. That's what we did last time. To address this problem, Henry Gourault introduced a method in 1971, which is known as smooth shading. Here we go. Or Gourault shading, whatever. The idea behind this technique is to produce continuous shading across the surface of the polygon mesh. Despite the fact that precisely the object that represents is not continuous, as it is built from a collection of flat surfaces. In order to do so, Gourault introduced the concept of vertex normal, which is what we have here in our mesh anyway. Normals in our mesh are always vertex normals, even when we do flat shading. The idea is simple. Rather than computing or storing the normal of the face, we store a normal of each vertex of the mesh, where the orientation of the normal is determined by the underlying smooth surface that the triangle mesh was converting from. When we want to compute the color of a point on the surface and triangle, rather than using the face normal, we compute a fake smooth normal, binarily interpolating the vertex normals defined at the triangle vertices using the hit point barycentric coordinates. What? Barycentric coordinates. The technique of interpolating any primitive variables, including colors, texture, or using the triangle barycentric has been studied a few times in the previous lessons. If you're not yet sure about how the method works, we recommend you to read the rasterization page for the lesson rasterization practical implementation. Okay, the technique is illustrated in the above video. So this is the face normals. That's correct. So basically what we have here in the correct order is that this vertex is going to have this normal right? Most likely. And this normal. So we want to have normals that are more gradual, right? Like we have here. We see here they're not exactly perpendicular on the normal itself. They're slightly angled. So the thing is blah, blah, blah. You can see that they are indeed perpendicular to the smooth underlying surface. Yeah. So they are perpendicular to the face, to the edge itself, where here they're perpendicular to the actual curve of the surface, to the potential curve of the surface. Sometimes triangles are not directly converted from a smooth surface. That's the case with us. We don't have a smooth surface. Basically, he means here when you have like a subdivision modifier in Blender, for example. And vertex normals have to be computed on the fly. That's what we do here. We want to compute on the fly. Different techniques for computing vertex normals when there is not a smooth surface computing from exist, but we want something. Ah, shit. Different techniques for computing vertex normals when there is not smooth surface to compute them from exist, but we know something here. So that's not going to work for me. I want to compute on the fly. For now, use the software server to do this. No. In fact, from a practical and technical point of view, each triangle has its own set of three vertex normals, which means that the total of vertex normals for a triangle mesh is actually equal to the number of triangles multiplied by three. So wait. Each triangle has its own set of three vertex normals. Yeah, which means that the total of vertex normals for triangle mesh is actually equal to the number of triangles multiplied by three. Correct. In some cases, the vertex normals define a vertex shared by two or three or more triangles, the same. But you can achieve different effects by providing them different directions. Okay, so we can actually change the normal here to fake edges, hard edges. The circle for computing the interpolated normal of any point on the surface of a triangle, as long as we know the vertex normal of the triangle, the percentage continuous of this point on the triangle, as well as the triangle index. Both rasterization of ray tracing provide you with this information. Vertex normals are presented by the model of by a 3D program that you have been using to create the model. They are then exported to the other. No, that's not what we want. Let's see the code. Yeah, I think we're gonna need another article for smooth shading. Okay, so let's see how to calculate smooth shaded normals, vertex normals in our case. Okay, let's take a look. Can I calculate smooth vertex normals? Okay, so let's take a look here. Okay, we have that as well. So if you look like for some kind of, what the fuck is a triangle slope? I don't get it. There are so many bots in Twitch. Don't they have a mechanism to block bots? that are spamming things. That's one thing I don't understand about Twitch. You know, how hard it is. So you average them and divide by 3. Average what? Okay. Oh, hello, quote unquote. Welcome, welcome. How is the game going? Thanks for the follow. When's the deadline? I see. Yeah. I tried to do, a game jam. I was doing the global game jam, right? Which is it the biggest thing, game jam of all? And I was participating through Global Game Jam Athens, because it happened in Greece, and it was 3 days, and it was so stressed, right? I made a mess. So that was the first and the last. I mean, it wasn't the first game jam I was being, but I was alone, because the previous game jam I had 3 people helping me, which was a lot easier. By doing game jam by yourself, making a game from scratch in 3 days, it's a torture. It's a big torture. So here we see a way to compute phase normals, which we already know. 24 hours, oh my God. 24 hours. That's a nightmare. No sleep. I mean, no sleep is okay, but you know, it's the stress, it's the pressure, you know. I don't enjoy it. I give up, I don't care. You know, I like to take my time, I like to think about things, you know. just I don't feel that I create anything meaningful in 5 hours or 10 hours. I mean, yesterday I was wasting 2 hours. I needed to invest 2 hours to be able to find how to calculate a normal. So, okay, yeah, but of course what I'm doing here is a lot difficult. I think the biggest mistake I made in the previous jam is that I did a 3D game. 3D games are pretty much a terrible idea for, unless you know what you're doing, unless you're experienced. They are very time consuming. I don't know, maybe 2D game. Actually, the next time I will go for a text game. I don't know. Game jams are very stressful, yeah. So this is for me, everything works normal, we don't care. What? So what we're doing here now in this stream is trying to find a way to shade smooth normals per vertex. What basically I'm trying to do is find faster ways to do normal calculations, because right now the only thing you have available in JDScript is the surface tool. The only thing. Or you import the module from Blender and it's already smooth shaded. So either you use a surface tool or you use an existing mesh that is already smooth shaded. But when you do procedure generation, you cannot really import modules, obviously, if you make everything from scratch. And the surface tool is not really fast enough for procedure generation. So I'm trying to figure out now how on earth I'm going to do this. I have calculated the normals. I'm doing flat shading, but I have to now do smooth shading. So how you do that? Are you improving the engine? You can say that I'm actually developing my own game engine. I'm developing an engine that's called Cycles, and it's going to be the only difference that is going to be a game engine that's specifically target for my game, which is going to be Hephaestus. And that game engine will specialize, very highly specialize, into procedure generation. So it's not going to be just graphics. Maybe I will do also item creation. Maybe I do also skill development, tech trees, you know, because procedure generation can be used pretty much for everything. So I want a collection of algorithms, obviously, and method calls and classes that will allow me to do this, yeah, to do this very fast. Now, from what I've seen, probably I will be doing it. Right now code everything in C++ because it's easy to debug. But probably I will be moving things to. I will be moving things to shaders, and probably also Vulkan Compute, which is why I want also to use Godot 4, because that things. From what I've seen some crazy acceleration up to 30 times, which is going to make it massively more accelerated than what Godot currently has. I could take a look at other code, like Zilan. This guy is really brilliant. He has done a voxel edging, which is not going to be dissimilar to what I'm trying to do. And he has created pretty much a nice, I think it's called Godot voxel engine. He implemented everything in C++. Godot voxel. So he specializes in voxels specifically, but it's not really something I care a lot about. But voxels can be used also to create complex, more realistic terrain, which is what I'm aiming for. So this is a typical voxel world, and this is more what I aim for. This is closer to what I aim for, which is also is voxels. The only difference is voxels have been smoothed to look much more organic. So that's actually his code. But I would like to make my own source code because I would like to understand how those things work. Because if I use his code, probably will not understand anything. I'm trying to do something similar, but not so much emphasis on the voxel part, much more emphasis on a bit more realism, and much more emphasis on procedure generation, which is also his own is procedure generated. It has infinite terrains. He has painting chunks, which is chunking something I will also implement. It has the ability to make your own generators, smooth terrain, and level of detail. Transvoxel, I don't know what transvoxel is. Transvoxel is what? Transvoxel, it's an algorithm for making voxel terrain. Cool. Okay, nice. So seamless is sticking together. Ah, that's actually useful. For seamlessly sticking together neighboring triangles meshes generated from voxel data at different resolutions so that the level of detail can be used with large voxel-based datasets such as volumetric terrain in next-generation video games. Cool. Okay. Yeah, I mean, there's so many things, man, you can do. I've seen that before for connecting triangles. The lookup tables. May use something similar myself, yeah. So yeah, it's complicated, yeah. I'm not in a rush to make the game. It doesn't matter if it takes me like 5-6 years, I'm fine with that. But I wanted to stream this because I know that there are not gonna be a lot of people that will be doing this kind of stuff, right, in Godot. Most people doing something more simple games, etc. And I think you guys have covered these corners very easily. So I decided to work myself on something much more complicated to see how far we can go with the Godot, because I think we can go pretty far. And already Zilan has showed us that you can do pretty impressive stuff here. It's really nice. There are some nice YouTube examples here as well, you can find. But for now, I'm focusing on how to compute the normals. So it doesn't say me how. Okay, we have this guy here says that we have to average the normals together based on their angle. So you weight the normals against an angle between the two neighbor vertices, the one shared in the edge corner. And what happens if they don't share a common angle? What do you do then? And how you know where the angle is? So he has an angle algorithm here. Does Godot have an angle algorithm? Does Godot have an angle to vector? Okay. So this is vector 2. Let's take a look at vector 3. So it should be in the vector 3 class. Okay, so... you have an angle. Nice. Angle 2, here we go. Does vector 3 also has the same thing? Vector 3. Don't see it. Nope. Direction 2. Distance. Ah, angle 2, yeah, of course. Yeah, here it is. Okay, so we can actually calculate the angle. Nice. In radians. How he calculates an angle? He uses... Okay, so... Is it in radians? Oh, we have P2 between T1 and P3 versus P1. So it's basically, this is it B minus A, C minus A? It's basically the same thing we'll be doing with normal calculation for flat shading. P3, P2, so it calculates the normals. It normalizes what? N, what is N? This is the normal, which you normalizes. I mean, my normal is already normalized. And we do what? So it calculates the normal here. which is what I've done. He normalized the and then he does what? Multiplies by, okay, so he finds the angle here. And that's gonna work, really? What is that? Wii normals, what is that? Wii normals, I don't know what that is. Wii normals. Wii normals, okay. What is a Wii normal? VM1 Wii normals. What it means Wii normals? Awaiting normals. Okay. Waiting normals. So do we have weight normals in Godot? Godot Wii normals. No, I didn't mean that. Okay, let's say weighted normals then. Weighted normals. Waiting for Godot, learning heuristics for what? Weighted normals. The Blender course. No? Okay. So waiting for Godot. That's very funny. My God. Okay, so here we have the mesh that all. Does the mesh that all has weight normals? I don't think so. Okay, so let's say weighted normals. Let's see. Okay. Special material normals. No. Okay, so let's first of all examine how smooth shading works. What? Wait, what? Hello? What happened? Let's see. Hello? Okay. How smooth shading works in Godot. Smooth shading. Okay. No, I don't want you in here. Smooth faces. So let's go here, shading. Your first shader, blah, blah. Okay, so Godot smooth shading. How to use smooth shading? Can I create smooth shading in Godot? So what? There's no such thing as flat shading in Godot. What? Oh. Okay, so if you import a model, it always is smooth shaded in Godot. Got you. Okay, so flat shading happens how? So basically calculate the normals here, most likely. Yeah, calculate the normals here. I don't want to do that. I already done that. Okay. So, yeah. So let's go back to this, because I think this one is the closest I find in understanding how to do this, because he doesn't talk about, where is the other guy? Is this one, let's close that one. So this one doesn't see anything weighted here, doesn't do any weighting. The current number, exploiting with exploitation with machine, the current number of vectors set by general normal, assign this normal to any subsequent vertex definition, invoke to achieve the flat shading. No, that's flat shading. For smooth shading, it's called to GL, must be preceded by a corresponding call to GL normal. What is GL normal 3? Okay, so for smooth shading, it's called to GL vertex, what? Flat shading, smooth shading. What? I think it does. What he's doing here is making an average. He must be doing another interpolation. Probably. Which I, from my understanding, is not going to be very efficient. I don't think he's doing anything else. He doesn't do any weighting kind of thing. So this guy here is doing without angle weighting. So this one is without using angle weighting. So this is actually using interpolation. What's the problem here? Why it is problematic? You can see the facet components begin all the same, but since some sides have two faces, correct? Their part of interpolation is doubled. Their part of the interpolation is doubled, making the average skewed. Where do you see the average skewed? I don't see much of a difference. Am I blind? I don't see much of a difference. Okay, it must be the numbers. No. Where's the difference? The planners are also matter of course. So this one. Okay, so let's close the code again. So this is the neighbor. Here he also only takes what really I find weird, he only takes the triangle itself. So let's say P2 and P3 are the points in the face, correct. He doesn't take any other face. Unless I'm he must take the first. He takes the vertex here. Okay, I get it. So he calculates a normal. I think I understand what he's doing here. So he creates a new normal array where you add only weighted normals, and here he only puts inside the angle, because this is the angle, right? And then uses this angle. Let's see. So he puts inside the angle for all the three vertices, which they make a triangle. And then he goes to all the vertices and through every single vertex, as long as it's not to the end of, he iterates through the list. And here he does what? Normalize n. What is n? What exactly is n? And why it matters? You don't return it. He defines an n variable. He never uses. Define a normal. So, okay, so he normalizes the normal that already had here. Okay, but he never pushed that normal back. Why? He doesn't put it anywhere. He doesn't insert it back to the list of normals, right? Unless is this one is doing that. So, yeah, obviously this should be the normal. So what we do here, we calculate one normal. So we have one normal here for float, blah, blah, which is going to give us the normal of the face. P1 is the base here. P1, what the hell is a P base? Probably means the first vertex. So he makes the cross product that we see we have done already with our normal. And then he calculates the angles for every single edge. Yeah. But the problem, however, here is that A1, N2, N3 in this case scenario, well, this is A0, A1, N2. So this is for the triangle, right? Get an angle between the other points for each point. The starting point will be the base, and the two advanced ones will be, let me go back, will be normalized against it. So basically it does the triangle, right? Because this is a triangle, if I'm not mistaken. P1, P3 are the points in the face, so it's a triangle. Okay. And of course, this is going to repeat for every triangle. And he calculates the angles of every edge of the triangle. Normalize the initial face if you want to ignore surface area. Normalize the initial face at normals if you want to ignore surface area. Okay. Normalize. If not, array weighting. Store the weighted normal in a structure array. So here it stores the normal. The weighted normal, which is basically the angles. 1, 2, 3, 4, every vertex. Okay. And then he goes through every single one of them. So we're going to need bye-bye, quad unquote. Thank you, man. Thank you for subscribing to YouTube. Thank you very much, man. Have a nice one. Good luck with your game. Probably will also hang out. See you if you are you going to stream today? You plan to streaming? If you plan to stream, I'll probably come later on. I'm not going to be streaming for very long. Probably another hour, maybe. We'll see. But yeah, thank you for hanging out, man. So, now we are only the two of us. So let's see how we're going to do this. I'm going to need to create a normal array that's going to store the weight in normals from the way I see it. And I will need also... The one thing I don't understand is he goes to every vertex. Well, no, he goes to every vertex and normalized it. So it does take an interpolation of all the vertexes. The only difference is that it uses a weighted way to do that. So how you do that? How you say non plus one? So vertex normal at n. What is n? What is n? What the hell? Wait, the n. Wait. N is the normal. Right? So what? If n is the normal, first of all, So how, why, what? First of all, what is that? What is that? What constant is this? This one is for, is it, where is it exactly? Which category? Algorithm 3D monomass vertices. Because I see a library here of functions, which I don't recognize. Ah, okay. He's working with C++. Ah, okay. It's DirectX11. Okay, okay. DirectX11. So let's take a look at that. Let's look at DirectX11. What does it mean? So DirectX11 Win normals. Let's see that. I've looked online for quite some time. I can find blah blah blah. That's basically the same thing that we find in Stack Overflow. Yeah, that's the same thing. Congratulations. Okay. Plus, I'm trying to understand how the code works. I'm trying to understand how the code works. Okay. So the big question here that I want to ask is, does the surface tool smooth set with using weighted average for normals? That's a good question. So let's take a look at what the surface tool is doing. Surface tool has a function that's called smooth groups. How you define a smooth group, and then we have to go to generate normals with a smooth group. So just look again all that generate normals thing. So okay, it's this one. So here's the code we saw the other time as well. So maybe this is why I didn't understand the code previously. This is why he's doing all the things he's doing. He wants to create the weighted normals, basically. Right? Because now it's not making more sense. He normalized the normal here. And then he moves to the next. In order to do that, that means that basically he's interpolating. But I don't think anywhere that find it that he's doing any form of weighting. I don't think there's any weighting because he doesn't create a weighted array. At least from the name, it doesn't seem so. Smooth groups has blah, blah, blah. That's the front. He iterates through the list of vertices. I think he uses this the next year. And then he does normal, plane, get vertex, vertex normal. So maybe it does that in order to create the surface tools. Maybe it does use the plane for this reason. Get vertex, and then generates a normal. So use the plane to generate a normal? How is doing the smooth? P flip. If smooth, get attribute, get pointer, set, Here we go. What LV means? List of vertices, probably. List of vectors. Vertex has set, get normal. Yeah. So here what he does is taking, and he adds to the normal, which basically is the same thing that we do here. Yeah, here it is. That's the same thing. So he actually does interpolation, but the algorithm doesn't really do any weighting. So he doesn't do that part here. Doesn't do that. He does a simple interpolation. That's about it. Okay. Okay. So we're going to be doing this here, but the problem, however, this one is probably going to end up being, okay, before doing that, let me take a look at this plane. Okay, so let's take a look at plane. So plane, okay, so this is a typical cross point. So this is a typical, I can actually decide the clockwise, P direction. So this is P direction, okay. Why did this not go back button? Right, go back. Let's see. Is there go back? Go to preference, go to dedication. There's no go back, huh? That's shit. Why? Why did it not go back? Anyway. So here it calculates basically. It's a typical cross-product thing. There's nothing really original. It has a cross-product that we did earlier. This one is different from what? If it's flip. So p-flip is basically the direction, right? Let's go back. Yeah, it's clockwise and anticlockwise. So this is the direction of the vertices. So it's clockwise here. So it's going to do that. So you actually can do clockwise and anti-clockwise. Okay, let's go back. So this one is anti-clockwise. So this is basically generally only the surface normal, nothing special about it. This is where the smoothing happens, and he goes through the vertices, and I think he basically interpolates, nothing else. Otherwise, he basically gets the normal as it is. He gives the same exact normal for all the... Yeah, he basically copies the same normal for all... So he has a normal here for the surface. And what he does here is... What we do here as well is... He does a normalize here. B yet. What is B? That's smooth groups count. He adds a smooth group. A smooth groups clear. So are smooth groups only used by the surface tool? That's a good question. Are they used only from the surface tool? It appears so. Really? Only from the surface tool? So let's give it another try. So there's only one, really, only the surface tool using smooth groups. Interesting. Okay. So add smooth group. Because it's smooth groups. Okay. Okay. Let's go with smooth group then. Really? The only one, no one is using other than, wait, add smooth group? Nobody's using other smooth group? Source, resource importer object. Add smooth groups. Okay. The surface tool is used here. So the surface tool is used for the resource importer for object files. Okay. What about FBX? What about GLTF? Oh my God. The internet is suffering again. A sitter and is suffering. So, yeah, from what I've seen here, the only way to do smooth... Wait. The only thing I see in terms of smooth groups... Yeah? Why is smoothing happens? The only place that the smoothing happens in the generate normals function. I don't think anything else happens. From the look of it, right? Yeah, this is the general normals here. This is general normals still. Yeah, it's on general normals. And of course, binding the method. Okay, we don't care about that. So, yeah. So from what I've seen, it does only a simple interpolation here. We can do also weighting. I don't know. Let's take a look again. Is it really necessary to do the weighting part? This is one thing I don't understand. He says here that there's a difference. I don't see any difference. I don't see a difference. So you can see the faster the components being all the same. The faster components, but since some sites have two faces, their part of the interpolation is double, making the average skewed. Where you see that? I don't see anything. Wait. I kind of see a difference here, maybe. Maybe a difference here, maybe. I don't know. Let's take a look. A bit of a difference. Yeah, I do see a bit of a difference here, in this area. What else? And this, yeah, there is a difference. Here also there's a bit redder. And this one is much more clear. Yeah, there is a leaking here. Okay. And what about, yeah, you can see it here and you can see it, you can see it also here. Yeah, this one is much greener in this area, I think, you know, maybe. But here is the most profound red. Here is a bit red. There is a bit of red. I barely see it. So it's not completely green. Where here is completely green. So this is the problem. This is the area that the problem exists mostly. Okay. So the big question is how accurate we want the normals to be. And the answer to that, well, if you use normal maps, you want them to be accurate. But why Godot doesn't do that? I presume because it's slower. Because you have to make another array, so you're actually going to make things slower in this case scenario. Okay, let's close the rest of those. Let's close that. I don't care. So let's get again, let's go how to calculate smooth set. Let's go again here. And polygons compute vertex normals for smooth shading. Okay, let's see that. That's also here uses. Okay, so let's go through a few resources more, because before doing that, I would like to make sure that what is that? Mathematica. Ah, that's Mathematica. Okay. Yeah, I don't think this is basically pre-made. No, I want to be able to implement this. Yeah, I want to implement this. That's not good enough. No, that must be mode of visualization way to what is that? No, that's not coding. That's Modo. I don't want Modo. Get out, Modo. You're drunk. Here, OpenGL. So, okay. What he's doing here? Normal. I think he's doing the cross product here. He normalizes then. Okay. Okay, let's get it. Wait, what? What happened? What? Why it doesn't open? What? It opens and closes. What the hell? On your window? Why it tries to download it? No, I don't want to download anything. Okay, let's go like that. No, I don't want to download anything. Maybe that, huh? No, we have. Okay, so. Terrain, I think it was terrain. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Okay, whatever. So what else we have? Waiting vertex normals. Okay. Okay, so let's move from this. Per polygon smoothing groups. Per polygon smoothing groups. Yeah, this is the accumulation that we're normally using. Okay, this is the problem we created when we do pure interpolation. And this is the alternative. I don't see much of a difference though. Which make me wonder, maybe we should be doing a simple interpretation, because frankly, I don't see much of a difference. I don't see much of it. It has this kind of, yeah, it has a bit more. Let's take a look at it. Yeah, there is a, yeah, the normals are a bit, yeah. Yeah, I see now. Yeah, it's the, yeah, it's a bit better, yeah. It's a bit better. Of course, the question here is, will it matter? Will it matter that we have it like that? When we have like, because you can have a geometry that's, here it's a very low poly model, which, okay, yeah, here I understand that the normal is gonna matter a lot. But when you have a high poly geometry, which probably we'll have, I don't think it's gonna matter that much. I don't think it's going to matter that much. I don't know. I do not know. As you can see, we can simply multiply the face normal by the triangle area when we cumulate. Since we already normalized the zoning value, we don't have to do anything else. Behold. Low poly collinear. So this is a low poly issue. It's not really so much. The only problem I have is with normal maps. It's going to be affecting my normal maps. So he says, since normal maps generation is often a design. Normal generation, there's no impact in performance. It's a design time process. He says basically that you have to make it inside the 3D application. No. No, there are mine are recalculated from scratch in real time. Yeah, probably I will have to go with the simpler version, which is what Godot also uses. Because Godot does the same thing with the imported objects. And there's not any noticeable problem there. So I will have to avoid the whole weighted kind of thing and just interpolate between the values. Yeah, use pseudocode, which I don't understand here. Angle between vectors. So this is actually the solution. This is the what we did earlier with the angle. So that's the one thing I also want to learn. The choice of angular units doesn't matter. So I want to see, because you can measure an angle in radians or in degrees. We're all familiar with degrees. I think radians is how many times you need to complete a circle. So it's the proportion of a circle, basically, right? The radians is usually the proportion of a circle. Where an angle is basically a measurement, right? How many degrees of angle you have. So it doesn't really matter. But the problem, however, is that we have to create a new vertex, a new normal array, which is going to have only the weights inside. It's going to be basically an integer array or a float array. But we already know that making arrays in Godot is kind of expensive. And that means we're going to get worse performance, most likely, than we were going to be getting with... So what I'm going to do is going to extract the code from the surface tool, because I think it's doing a very typical interpolation, trying to understand a bit better, trying to compare it with the code we have here, which uses weights. I'm not going to use weights because, again, I don't want to sacrifice performance and I don't want to generate more arrays than I have to, because this one is going to require an additional array and it's going to have to require probably additional iteration through the array. Well, not really. No, because it takes the array at the point it is. But it has to generate the array. It has to go through and make the array itself. So we have to do another action when we do those things. And this is going to be expensive. It's not going to be crazy expensive, most likely, but it's going to add, it's going to decrease in performance. And most likely, we will have to look for ways to reduce performance. And also simplifying the process may make it also easier to port it to a shader. So I want to keep this as simple as possible. So what I'm going to do is basically do a simple interpolation. So what we're going to do next, I will take a break. And what we're going to do next is we're going to go back to the surface tool, take a look again on this thing, and just extract the code. Extract the code that we have here. And I want to actually study surface tools, because the thing is that we have to also... If you want to make it easy to interact with other objects inside Godot, we have to also make sure that we define surface groups in the way that that God defines surface groups. I don't think it's really that complicated, but I want to take a bit closer look to see exactly how God defines the surface tools, in the sense the surface tool, how it defines smooth groups, sorry, not surface groups, smooth groups inside Godot, and trying to imitate that. And do the simple interpretation that is doing here. We ignore this because this is basically what we have already done. Yeah. And we're get to go. So all we have to do is basically do this. This is the part we need. We don't need this part, we already do that. We only need this part. So all you have to do is just understand what they're doing here and call it a day. Okay, we'll take a break for a few minutes and yeah, we'll be back shortly. Thank you, everybody.
Hello, I'm back. Okay. Okay, let's see. What happened here? It's streaming forever. But let's take a look. Let's see. Okay. Yep, okay. For some reason, my central panel Twitch is... Okay. Since we are back. Okay. So take a look at this, the code, and see exactly what's going on. Okay, so this is the code. So from what I've seen, we haven't seen anything doing weird with smooth groups. I think the only thing that does smoothing is on the surface tool. And from what I've seen, surface tool is not really used inside Godot so much for anything else. So we're going to copy paste this code basically. So this one is doing what? So this one is using the LV, which is defined inside here. So this is the LV. This is the VY and the LV. And so he says here, if LV is not defined, I think this is when you have a null pointer. Do that. You basically add the normal to the normal, and then you normalize it. So LV equals with normal plus normal, right? LV equals LV plus normal. But the LV always gets a normal, right? It averages the normals of the triangle only. It doesn't go through the entire vertex array, right? Does it? Okay, let's see if there's a for loop. Yes, there is a for loop here. Okay, so it does go that. But it doesn't really take anything else into account. So VI is 1, 2, 3. V is 0, so V E E U R. So vertex array front. So front is gonna give us the top element, and that's the B. B is the first element. Poor face the VB E. What? So it doesn't do anything. Maybe this is the reason why it goes next. And when exactly stops, if there's no comparison, how it stops the for loop? This is something I don't understand somehow. So let's do this. Let's do this the easy way. We're going to have to use the debugger here. We would see exactly how it works. So let's go here, and I'm going to have to change the setup to make it as simple as possible. Let's go debug. Let's go Ifostos, and change that to... script. And change that to a very simple, let's say 10 by 10. So 100 is not that bad. Let's take 10, but I think 10 by 10 should do the trick. Let's close that. And now let me do, let's go here. Let's go there basically and do a debug session
So let's do the debug session. It's going to have to compile things. I haven't changed anything, so it shouldn't be taking any time. So we have to take a look here how it iterates to the array and if it does anything fancy. I don't think it's doing anything fancy. I think it basically interpolates to the normals. And and I think should be fairly simple. So we have to position that part because I'm not going to be using that. And I'm going to go through the code step by step as soon as the debugger loads. If it loads, when it loads. So the watch here have watch. I can add variables here to watch. Actually, yeah, there's not a bad idea to watch these variables. So let's watch some variables. So we want to watch V, first of all. We want to watch also E, it's capital E. We want to watch also normal. And we want to watch also, what else we have? LV. And we want also to LV, which is the pointer to the normals, I think. So this is how we are now in the first step. We go through here. It de-indexes things. That is actually a bit troubling because I don't know what it does here. I think it removes the double triangles, which can be a bit of an issue when we have, in my case. So, okay, let's... What? Wait, what? Oh, shit. What the hell? No. I pressed the wrong button. It's okay. Come on, debugger. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Why it takes forever? Okay, here we go. So, de-indexed. We go from the index. Actually, I should have gone inside the de-index, see exactly what it does. Yeah, screw it, I'm gonna do it again. I want to go through the index and see exactly what it does. Away to feel the sun. The sun is storming up of light. I have to find why the debugger takes so much so long to trigger. It just doesn't make any sense. Okay, so we're gonna go over that and we're gonna go inside that, the index. So let's see how the index works. So let's take a look. The first stage is gonna go through that, vector array, array, resize. Right. Okay, so let's look at the documentation. So go.dindex. Go.dindex. Cephalostool. Okay. Let's take a look, see what exactly is going on here. Okay, so dindex, what the hell is a dindex? Index, the index. So removes the index array by expanding, removes the index array by expanding the vertex array. What? Why? Removes the index array by expanding the vertex array. That doesn't make any sense. Why? So, but wait. Generates a tangent vector for each vertex. Requires that each vector has UVs and normal set already. A tangent vector. Oh, no. Shrinks the vertex array by creating an index array. Shrinks the vertex array. Okay, so it removes the vertex reuse. Oh, I see. Okay. Mm-hmm. So basically, it can remove the index array and expand and duplicate vertices in order to construct. And what it does, it shouldn't then do, should do an index then. So it basically has to do only with the, whether the index array is present and whether there is a duplicate vertices. Okay. So this one is shrinking the vertex array, which means the index is okay. So the index is shrinking the vertex array, which basically means it removes all the duplicates. Where then the index expands the vertex array by adding back the duplicates. This is not something we have to worry about because we create the duplicates in our vertex array anyway. Because they share the same vertices, different triangles share the same vertices. So I don't have to worry about the indexing myself in this case, which is good. One thing less to worry about. So I can get out of this one. I don't need to deindex anything. Get out. Thank you. So let's move to the next step. In count zero. Now, the in count zero, it has never been used unless I'm an idiot, I'm not seeing it. Where the count is has been used again? Let's expand the watch here because we're going to be using that. Where's the count is used? Just has a count, but never uses it. No, it's never used, the count here, unless I'm missing something. In count is zero. And where we see count? I don't see it anywhere. Nope. Nope. Oh, count plus three. So it adds three here. Ah, okay, it uses here. Smooth groups has three. What? Okay, let's take a look at the count as well. Count. So let's look at the vertex has as well. Let's take a look at all the variables to know exactly what we're doing. Vertex has. Okay. So. Okay. So let's go to the next one. Smooth is on false. Smooth is on false. Okay, this is the value. Do we have smooth groups? We don't have smooth groups. So let's add smooth groups as well. Smooth groups. Okay, so we don't have any smooth group here. So this one must be empty. And it is. Okay, so let's go. This one has zero. It doesn't have zero. So it doesn't have zero. So it doesn't have any smoothing group. It examines if there's not smoothing groups, obviously, because the first time it creates this. Then goes to the element B. So we're gonna set the B here, which haven't added to watch list. So add B. What the hell? Add B here. B. Okay. So let's go with B. Okay. So the first one is this one, and it has value of vertex. That's what I'm gonna care about. Anonymous union coordinates 0, 1. I think this is the first one. 0, 1. I think it's the first one, if I'm not mistaken. I think the first one is, let me relocate this. I think the first one is here. Where is it? Surface tool, mesh create. So the first one was, where is it? What is that? No, that's a quad. I don't want a quad. I want the, where is it? I want this one. 0, 1, yeah. So this one is the first one. 0, 1 is goes to the first one, so that's correct. Let's go back here. So this one is the first one. So it gives us basically the top of the list. Gives us the top of the list. So this is why I call it front. So this is the top of the array. Okay, so the B has the top. Okay, this one is top. Can I comment this? It would be nice if I could comment things. So I cannot, anyway, so we have the top here, and then we have V0. So V is now having what kind of values? V, so if that is the B, then B is a pointer of B. So B is a very wrong. So it copies the front there to E. And then why? Wait, E is what? Same thing with V. Well, technically V has different structure. It has what is that? It is the, what is that? Value. No, that's different. This is 1.5. What is that? 1.5. Oh, no, they're not defined yet. No, those are defined values. So the V hasn't defined yet? No, it hasn't defined yet. So now it's going to define it. Let's define it. Okay. So the V0 in this one. So this one must be... Okay, so basically what it does here, it creates the triangle. So it calculates the triangle here. Okay. Creates the triangle as a triangle. So this is the first one. The second one, and says it's the next one after V0, because it has the V array here. So V is taken from where? It's taken from here. List vertex element. So it lists the vertex element, V3. So it's this one is the V1, this is V2. So basically those are the triangles. This is the triangle. V1 next, V0 next. So use the next function here. So basically, this is what we have been doing with -1, -2, and -3. My way was a bit more crude, but this one is using a next method. So V0 next, it's going to go to the next iteration. Okay. So I think this one is the beginning, and this one is the end.
And then it actually, okay, so I get it now. This is the beginning of the beginning of the vertex array, which is, has the three vertexes for the triangle, and is the end. Okay, so now things have makes, why they cannot name the variables? Why it's so difficult to name the variables, right? I don't get it. I don't like variables that are single single letter. It's pretty annoying. So anyway, so this one is a thing when it's not clockwise or not clockwise. Basically, it's the v. Yeah. So basically, this is the order of. We don't really care about that. This is only for calculating the normals. We know that the normals is correct for the surface because this is the surface normal. And then we go and we do, let's see. Actually, this is going to tell us, yeah, this one is the clockwise I'm using. And then goes to smooth. If smooth, this is not going to execute now because I haven't really said that it should be smooth. Yeah. So here, so basically what it's going to do here, unfortunately, the LV is not going to be used here. I have to make it smooth. So in order to read smooth, it has to have already smooth groups. So we have to add a smooth group. So we have to change the code in here. Change the code and add the smooth group. Add smooth group. Yeah, that's the only way to do it. If you want to also iterate through the smooth group, let's do that. How you do that? Add smooth group. Bones. Add smooth group. Ah, you have to do it for every vertex. Oh, so I cannot do that. Yeah. What will happen if I hack this manually? Can I hack this manually? Smooth groups. Okay, let's take a look at smooth groups. First of all, where was it? It was if smooth. So if smooth is defined from smooth group here. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is let it iterate, because it's not going to iterate through everything, right? He's going to come back. So let me come back. Or he doesn't come back. Why doesn't come back? Ah, it has to be called. Yeah, that was a stupid me. Oh, well. Okay, let's do it again. That happens when you don't really know what you're doing. Okay. Yeah, I don't think it's really that difficult. It should be pretty simple. Because from the looks of it, let's take a look at the code. From the looks of it, this code here, it gets LV, which is a vertex. I don't understand what this is really is. This one, V1, etc., is, yeah. So it does the same thing. And it gets the normal for that, but normal from where? No, I think it generates the normals here. No, actually, what? Okay. Let's first of all do it again. Okay, so here I have to go and change and say that smooth equals true. Smooth equals true. I think it's true. Okay. Let's see if that's going to work this time. No, I don't care about this. Okay, let's see if it's going to work. S-
So it still is true. So now it's after work.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's see what happens here. The LV is this one. So LV is what? Coordinates. It's empty. It doesn't have anything. Okay, so let's go here. It still is empty. It's basically, from what I've seen, this must be a null pointer, no? Or not? It's zero. So, okay, let's take a look at the vertex it has. Vertex has is this one. There's no vertex has? That can't be true. Vertex has. No, there is a vertex has. Nope, there is. So vertex has okay, we don't have to do that. We go with LV. So LV is zero. Okay. So what is that? LV. Vertex has get pointer. I think that, I don't know. Vertex has set, get, normal. What the vertex has is exactly? Set, normal, get normal. What is the normal? The normal is this one. This is the normal, which is the surface normal. So it doesn't accumulate the normal there. Why? Because the first normal? Yeah, probably, yeah. No, you still make the same thing. LV is now. Interesting. So it goes back to the list, to the for loop. Okay. It has a smooth again. Wait, what? So it doesn't get. I'm confused. Wait, is smooth now true still? She's still true. Why doesn't execute the second one? I don't know. I do not know. Okay. Let's make it here. Let's see if we go here, ever executes here. Nope, it never executes this one. So this one is completely useless. Why? I don't know.
Must be like a dictionary. Okay, so I'm going to end the stream here. I probably will have to research a bit more to make sure that I understand what's doing here. I'm not 100% certain, I'm kind of tired. So yeah, I'm going to stop the stream here. Thanks everybody for watching. And yeah, we're going to come back to this. It's really, we have to, let me change the name a bit. We have to do a bit more research in this area. Because, we are not 100% certain what's going on right now. So, yeah, thanks everybody for watching, and we'll see you on the next stream. So, bye-bye.